If you're watching the Young Turks, chances are that you accept or at least understand the human caused climate change. You probably know more than the average person. So we've got a very interesting little consequence of climate change, and that is that vast regions of the north near the Arctic Circle are thawing out. What used to be tundra is now land that can actually sustain plant life. And so these massive forests are growing, and so we've got some interesting quotes regarding that. As a result of enhanced warming and a longer growing season, large patches of vigorously productive vegetation now span a third of the northern landscape, or more than 3.5 million square miles, or 9 million square kilometers. That is an area about equal to the contiguous United States. That's amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not that just that it's happening, and I've seen actually some of the damage that the thawing of the tundra can do in terms of like taking down buildings and things like that, but just the sheer amount of vegetation that's popping up.
Yeah, it's something that most people aren't really aware of because it doesn't get covered much in the corporate mainstream media, mm-hmm. but you know what NASA has done, this is based on satellite measurements and other measurements, but they found that that vegetation has moved north by about 7 degrees latitude in just 30 years. Now that's because that's only as far back as the satellite record goes. We've only had them up there for about 30 years now. But it's a pretty stunning measurement, and it does show that the Arctic is changing. We already know the Arctic is changing faster than the rest of the globe. It's actually warming faster than the rest of the globe. This past summer we had a record Arctic sea ice extent. It was the lowest it's been. Mm-hmm. So these are various changes that are happening right now that NASA is screaming their heads off trying to get people to pay attention to. There's a couple of other things. You can check all of these out at our website, greennews.bradblog.com. That's where we have all of the links to all of this stuff. Just want to hit these really fast, but there was another study that came out last week that the recent heat spike that we've been observing right now is the highest that it's been in 11,000 years. They were able to actually go back and take the hockey stick graph that has been very popular among climate science deniers, and they've actually extended it back to 11,000 years. And they do see that the temperature spike that we've seen in the last 100 years is unprecedented since the last ice age, and that's using 76 sites around the world, 36 proxy measurements. You know, there's been quite a bit of information coming out in just the last week, you know, and you just don't hear about this on most of the media. So thank you guys for covering it.
Yeah, no problem. So really fast, obviously this is the first that I'm hearing about this vegetation. Could that actually in some way help with the problem because it would trap more carbon? Mm-hmm. Or is it unlikely to matter much?
It's not enough to matter, you know, mm-hmm. that right now vegetation in the oceans together absorb about 2/3 of the excess carbon dioxide that human activities put out. We're still putting out far more than natural processes can be absorbed in the natural carbon cycle.
Yeah.
You know, this is somewhat related to the story, but obviously, you know, different countries are thinking of different policies that can help lower carbon emissions. And one thing that I read that I found really fascinating, I don't know if you've seen this, but in China, in Beijing, actually, they're trying to ban things like barbecues. Because they think that would solve at least part of the problem. Now, of course, China uses more coal than all countries combined. So that's pretty much the big issue there.
Yeah.
But I mean,
most of it from barbecues, probably.
Most of it from barbecues, yes.
Well, there is a little bit of science. You know, there is a component of science that does point out that wood burning and other types of inefficient fossil fuel burning, including and forest as well, biomass. You know, that it doesn't burn efficiently, so you get, you know, soot. That's the black carbon that, you know, you find in your pollution. And if we could just pass laws that help people in poorer countries, say, get a solar oven or another kind of heating oven so they don't have to use kerosene.
George Foreman grill.
Okay, you know, maybe if they could have electricity first, that might help. But, you know, there are studies that show that if we can cut out this black carbon, then that would actually take care of about a third of the immediate near-term warming that we are looking at, you know, because it actually accelerates feedback.
That's incredible.
That's why when you hear former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton talking about this the cook stoves program that the United Nations started, you know, that's really important because it actually is not just a short-term health issue for women who have to cook these interior inside where they have the smoke and the soot and the pollution from that, but it's also a long-term and near-term climate fight.
See, you learn something when you bring scientists other than, like me and you,
scientist.
Political scientists.
Yeah.
Well, somebody who understands science to a degree higher than us. You learn something new every day. So final point on this I think is interesting. It's obviously great, you know, or at least it's interesting that this vegetation is popping up in the north, but don't get too used to it. because it's coming up because of climate change, but climate change might actually be the death of it as well. It says, however, researchers say plant growth in the north may not continue on its current trajectory. The ramifications of an amplified greenhouse effect, such as frequent forest fires, outbreak of pest infestations, and summertime droughts, may slow plant growth.
Yeah, so CO2 does help plants grow, but good luck with that if you don't have any rain. Yeah.
Oh, well, enjoy it while it's there.